This video will show you how to set up and program your PE700 series pull and spa wireless smart timer with the Intermatic Connect app. For this example, we are demonstrating the three circuit model, the PE733P. The first step is to download the Intermatic Connect mobile application from the Apple App Store or Google Play and open it. If the app doesn't take you directly to the login screen, click Login at the top right of the display. The next screen will ask you to log in or create an Intermatic Connect cloud account. You can skip this step if you don't have access to the email account that you want to use to control the timer. For this example, we do have access, so we will choose Create Account at the bottom of the screen. The next screen will ask you to enter your email address and create a password with at least 8 characters, including uppercase and lowercase letters, a number, and a special symbol. To accept the privacy policy and terms and conditions, check the box and click Continue. A 6-digit access code will be emailed to the address you provided. Minimize the app and find this code in your email. You can copy and paste the access code or type it in manually. Now choose Create Account at the bottom of the screen. Now that your account is created, you can scan for your timer, but you must make sure that Bluetooth is enabled. Go into the settings on your mobile device and scroll down to the Intermatic Connect app to verify that Bluetooth and local network have been enabled for the app. Now go back to the Connect app and press the plus icon. Choose Pull Timer. The app will scan for your timer. When you see New Timer listed, press Wink to make sure the app recognizes the correct timer. You should see the network light intermittently flash blue and the manual light flash a steady yellow. Now that you've verified it's the correct timer, click on the arrow to proceed. The next screen will ask you to put your timer into pairing mode. To do this, press and hold down the mode button until the network LED blinks rapidly. The next screen will ask you to rename the timer. For this example, we will name it Pull Timer and then press Next. The app will now ask if you would like to combine circuits 1 and 2 to handle 240 VAC applications. For this example, we are adding a 240 VAC pump, so we will choose Yes. Your individual circuits will be listed, which you can enable or disable and rename. For this example, we will name circuit 1 and 2 Pump, because they will control the pull pump. And we will name circuit 3 Pull Light to control the light. Click Next to continue. Now that our circuits are set up, we can connect the timer to our Wi-Fi network by pressing Connect to Network. Choose your network from the list and then type in the network password. Now press Connect. If you cannot find your network listed or if it's a weak signal, you may need to extend your Wi-Fi coverage with a range extender or mesh networking system. After pressing Connect, your timer will connect to your Wi-Fi and then connect to the cloud. This usually takes about 2 full minutes. It's important to keep the app screen visible during this process. The network LED will flash blue and then may transition to yellow. It will become a steady green once it's connected to Wi-Fi. Once the cloud setup is complete, click View Schedule to proceed. Since we have not yet set up any schedules, the weekly view will be empty. For our first schedule, we want to control the pump to run between 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. Click the plus button and choose Basic Scheduling. For the first event, we will choose On to turn the pump on and leave every day of the week selected. Now choose Time and click inside the box to choose 10 a.m. For the output, select Pump, which is controlled by circuits 1 and 2. Now click Save. On the weekly view, you will see a continuous line since an On event has been set without an Off event. To fix this, press the plus button and again choose Basic Scheduling. For this event, we want the pump to turn off, so we will leave off selected. Again, leave all days of the week selected. For time, click in the box and scroll to select 6 p.m. Again, select the pump as your output and then click Save. Now you can see a line in the weekly view showing when the pump will be on. To set a schedule for the pool light, press the plus icon again. Choose Basic Scheduling. Select On to set the on event. We want the pool light to turn on every day at sunset, so leave every day selected. Under Time, choose Sunset. Because the app synced with the calendar and your location during setup, the time for sunset will change automatically each day based on your location and the time of year. You can offset this time up to plus or minus 120 minutes. But for this example, we will keep it at sunset. For output, choose Pool Light, which is controlled by Circuit 3, and then press Save. As you can see, we need to set an off event for the pool light as well. So click the plus button and choose Basic Scheduling. Under Event Action, leave off selected, as well as every day of the week. We want the pool light to turn off every day at 11 p.m. So under Time, click in the box and scroll to select 11 p.m. For output, again choose the pool light, which is controlled by Circuit 3, and then press Save. Back on the weekly view, you can see the times when the pump will be on, indicated by a blue line, and when the pool light will be on, indicated by the orange line. Clicking on the downward arrow will bring up the details of each event. As you can see, the pump is scheduled to turn on at 10 a.m. and off at 6 p.m. The pool light is scheduled to turn on at sunset, which is 5:37 p.m. for this location at this time of year, and then turn off at 11 p.m. To enable these programs, make sure your timer is in auto mode. There are three ports on the PE700 series timers to add input devices, like an override switch, photo control, or presence sensor. For this example, we want to add an override switch to also control the pool light. To set this up, tap on Settings, which is the gear icon at the bottom of the screen. Now press Inputs. Enable Override 1. For type, choose Switch. And for output, choose Circuit 3, which we set up to control the pool lights. Now click Save. Once the override is enabled, you can use a remote switch to override the schedule and turn the lights on or off. On the next screen, you can set an input override time, so that when the switch turns the lights on, they will automatically turn off after a set period of time. You can also set this to be infinite, so that they will stay on until they are switched off. For this example, we will set the input override time to 30 minutes. In an override state, the circuit light will blink green until the override times out, and then the device will return to its current scheduled state. Click Save to lock in these settings. To view the timer's status, press Home on the upper left. From here, you can remotely turn circuits on and off. To enable the programs we just set, change the timer mode to Auto. The next timer event is listed under the circuit name. And you're done! Your PE700 series timer has been set up and programmed, and you can remotely connect to the timer through your Intermatic Cloud account. And if you get stuck at any point in the process, you can contact technical support at the phone number and email address shown on the screen. If you have questions or comments, please leave them below or visit intermatic.com. And be sure to check out our other videos on YouTube or the Intermatic webpage for more tutorials.